What 3Blue, 1Brown has done for mathematics is unsurpassed, not only with the channel, but with the Summer of Math Exposition contest, which, for those of you who are unfamiliar, is less of a contest and more of an ethos to create mathematical explainer videos collectively during the same time period. I'm a huge, huge fan of Grant Sanderson, the person behind 3Blue, 1Brown, and the Summer of Math Exposition contest, and thought, well, since this channel, Theories of Everything, is about physics and consciousness studies, why not do a similar contest, but on those topics instead? A few weeks ago, I emailed Grant, just to not step on any toes, so to speak, and he said, go for it. So today, I'm announcing the Physics and Consciousness Explications Contest. Essentially, it's a place and a period for you to submit your video explainer of a physics phenomenon or of a consciousness phenomenon or theory. We'll go into exactly what that means shortly. And Brilliant has similarly come on board with $1,000 to give to each one of the top five winners. That is 5,000 divided among five. I'll make a video with the top explainer videos. Of course, that's extremely subjective. And so I'll be supplementing that with a playlist inventorying each of the entries. So what's the point of all of this? Well, number one, it's not to have winners. It's to have more disquisitions on topics that don't have readily digestible tutorials out there, at least not publicly. Number two, it's to give a nudge to you or to someone you know who you want to share this with, who is on the perimeter of deciding to make a video but is unsure. Perhaps this scant incentive of being recognized with views or recognized financially with a prize pushes you in the direction of making content that you may not have otherwise. Number three, the top comments on the 3Blue, 1Brown YouTube video about the contest is something that I resonated with. Blar Goner, this user said that it's unfortunate that the more advanced videos, which explicitly assumed some prerequisite knowledge, got downvoted and flagged as being unclear, not explaining jargon, etc., despite such entries indeed being allowed by the general guidelines. In the future, consider having different levels of submission, for example, advanced. The point is, I have also found that a large segment of the YouTube population is starved for content, for advanced content, perhaps at the graduate or upper year undergraduate level. However, most of the content out there is directed toward the high school level. The TOE podcast, at least in some ways, can be thought of as speaking to that starved segment, though while in podcast form, much can be traversed quickly, much concepts verbally, still plenty is lost because there aren't equations and animations. It would be great if that lacuna was filled, that is, more advanced graduate topics, since the lower year undergraduate topics seem to get all the attention. So for example, if you have a thesis or a capstone project for your master's or your PhD, and you'd like to distill it down to its essence, then communicate it via video and submit. Let's get on to tips. So number one, choose a video that you would like to see created, a video that you wish existed, and perhaps even in the style that you wish existed. Number two, don't just use PowerPoint slides and talk through it. Okay, so what are some ideas of potential videos to be submitted? Well, firstly, if you're unsure, join the Discord, the link will be in the description, as well as you can just visit tinyurl.com/discordtoe, that is T-O-E, but onto some examples. What is Yang-Mills theory? How does the Atiyah-Singer index theorem relate to physics? What is a Lagrangian submanifold? And why is the symplectic creed that everything is a Lagrangian submanifold? What's an Euler class? Or if you're daring, what's the Chern-Gauss-Bonnet theorem's implications for supersymmetry? What is E8 as a Lie group, and what's that's relation to the E8 lattice? Or you can take some theory of everything that exists, so string theory, and explain some concept within it, or for example, Wolfram's physics project and explain how black holes are formed, or the maximum quantum entanglement speed, or in loop quantum cosmology, perhaps you'd like to explain what Ashtakar variables are and why they're useful. What's a sigma model? What's the symplectic version of quantum mechanics? How do you formulate quantum mechanics without complex numbers? And what are the trade-offs and benefits? Now, on the consciousness side, some example videos would be to explain Yosha Bock's computational model of consciousness. Now, hey, good luck with that. Or to explain Bernardo Kastrup's analytical idealism. Or to explain why phi has anything to do with consciousness in integrated information theory, or why it may not, and you can explain global neuronal workspace theory. What are the technical problems, perhaps epistemic, perhaps ontological, with having neural correlates of consciousness be an explainer of consciousness? How does Douglas Hofstadter's strange loop concept work, and where does it fall short? You can even combine consciousness and physics with an explainer of orchestrated objective reduction, that's Penrose's theory, or perhaps you can explain just an aspect of it, that is, what is Frohlich resonance? There was a study recently that apparently shows some limits of certain quantum theories of consciousness. Well, does it? What are the limitations of this study? What is Conway's free will theorem? It doesn't have anything to do with free will. What is superdeterminism? And now we're back on the physics side. Sabine Hossenfelder is working assiduously on that. So you're welcome to email her and say, hey, would it be okay if I took some voice clips of yours from this timestamp and this timestamp and added animations, perhaps your own narration? Some people in the TOE audience are studying neuroscience, and so if you want, you can show how machine learning is related to concepts in consciousness or qualia or perception, because perhaps that's what you're writing your PhD thesis on. Feel free to go ahead and make a video, even if it means that you're submitting to two different places, like your advisor, perhaps another contest. That doesn't matter to me. In fact, I encourage it because it adds extra motivation. I should emphasize that you don't have to submit an idea that incorporates both physics and consciousness, but instead, it's best to just focus on one of the two, that is, make a physics submission or make a consciousness submission, as generally, those that try to combine both tend to lack the rigor that we're aiming for with PACE 1. There are exceptions, of course. Again, if you're unsure if your idea for your video fits, then visit the Discord and ask. That's tinyurl.com/discordtoe. Okay, so what are the rules? Well, number one, you're allowed to submit to multiple contests. That is to say, if you're submitting to Summer of Math Exposition number 2, that doesn't preclude you from submitting here as well. Another rule is that you must make your video public. It can't be unlisted because the primary point is to have more commentary and explorations on physics and consciousness, both prevalent and overt. Number 3, unlike the 3 blue, 1 brown video, this is exclusive to video content, so no blog posts are allowed. Number 4 is make sure that you have one entry per group or per individual, and it also needs to be in English. Another rule is to please use the hashtag that's on screen in your submission title. And lastly, the deadline for submission is October 12th, 2022, 11:59 p.m. Toronto time. I don't want to be kept too late past my bedtime. Now let's get to what are some possible styles for the videos. So obviously, you could do a lecture with a blackboard and a tablet. That's not terribly engaging, but perhaps you can make it so. There's animation. That's the 3 blue, 1 brown style. That's extremely difficult, but wonderfully engaging. Number 3, you can make it a documentary style. So I'll give some examples of those on screen right now. Number 4 is you can make it exploratory, where you throw out ideas. It's you learning the topic, you going through a journey. You're showing your mistakes along the way, open questions you still have, showing connections between different fields and related concepts. It's not you as an expert, it's you as a student learning the topic. Another style is to take some work that exists and remix it, with the original creator's permission, of course. So for example, Richard Borchardt's Leech Lattice Explanation, or Donald Hoffman here, or like I mentioned with Sabine Hossenfelder and Superdeterminism. Another style is to take an article or a paper that you want to learn, and then you go through it. So for example, the papers that got Witten the Fields Medal, at least in part, the Jones Polynomial. You go through it, and then you explain it, maybe line by line, or maybe paragraph by paragraph, or page by page. Or combine it with animations, or simply just remix it with any of these styles. Okay, so now, what are the criteria for winning? Again, please, this is not about winning. This is simply to have more explications out there. However, if you're interested, one of the criteria is to take something that's traditionally complex and then make it digestible. So that is this ratio between complexity and simplicity. So for example, elucidating what Yang-Mills theory is rigorously is notoriously difficult. Perhaps you can find some analogies to make it more digestible. Not exactly simple, simple's the incorrect word. Number 2, it needs to be engaging and entertaining. And then number 3 is that you keep in the rigor. So no hand waving, no, if you're doing something regarding consciousness, no using the word quantum, as some, let's say, New Age people may incorrectly use the word so that they sound more scientific. Instead, for this contest, please stick to equations, precision, and logical rigor. And when I say rigor, I mean a physicist rigor, which essentially is a mathematician's hand wavy, but you understand what I mean. Good luck, and again, if you have questions, go to the Discord, which is linked below, tinyurl.com/discordtoe. As well as it's in the description. For the rest of this video, I'll be going through some examples of explications that exist that I think are particularly wonderful.
We'll be right back.